It was 2019. I did a Kickstarter for a light-up bow tie.
Nice. And the glow tie.
The glow tie, yeah.
Yeah.
And I had a very modest goal, and I only had to make 100 of them. And I had to solder all the components by hand to
yourself.
Make...
Yourself?
Just, yeah.
How many did you move? 100?
It was 100 glow ties, so okay. It was like... 3,000 components or so by hand that I had to solder, and
all through hole surface mount.
They
foundation.
Were almost all surface mount, and I for the first half I did them all like soldering iron by hand.
Yeah, I kind of like that, but you don't want to do that at scale at all.
You know, that was exactly the trade off I had because I was doing them by hand, and I like doing
it's
it
very
by
zen,
hand.
Yeah,
it's super zen. It's great. And then I was like, okay, I'm not going to be able to keep up. Like, I have to get these things out the door. So I finally got a stencil, and I did the solder paste thing.
Nice.
And I put them in my little frickin' toaster oven that I, you know, set up to, like, do the reflow and all that. And that worked better, but it still sucked.
Yeah.
It was not great. So at the end of this, I was like, how much is a pick and place to have this happen for me? And, like, you're looking at 60 grand minimum for, like, a reasonable thing. You can get, like, a Neoden, which is, like, 20K nowadays.
Interesting.
But... it's expensive, and, like, the software isn't great, and, like, it's hard to get it to do weird stuff and, like, get it to program your stuff, too.
When you're at the low end of any kind of tool, right, I mean, the software's not going to be great because it's such an expense to do in terms of non-recurrent engineering.
Totally. Yeah, absolutely. And, like, and it's a weird thing of, like, trying to figure out how to populate components. Like, there's machine vision. There's, like, generating G-code and, like, tool pathing, and, like, there's weird stuff going on in there. It's, like... it's not straightforward writing something like that. So
I actually haven't done it personally, but I can imagine just based on the fact that there's so many industries that exist around it.
Yeah, 100%. It's a lot. So I was like, okay, so I could either like pay someone through the nose to get them populated like at some assembly shop or buy a pick and place, or I could do them hand soldering. And I don't want to hand solder them. I don't want to pay through the nose. I don't want to buy a pick and place. Let me try and make a cheaper one. With effectively just like using all the hardware that you use in an FDM printer, like stepper motors and like a standard off the shelf like 3D printer controller and like 3D printer firmware, it's effectively doing the same thing. You have to do some weird stuff to get it to work, but like a 3D printer is not tremendously different from a pick and place. There are other things you have to add in, but like with the cool hardware boom of like FDM printers, stepper motor cost came down, linear rail cost came down, a GT2 timing belt cost, like all the little greeblies you need. So much cheaper. That's awesome. I was like, why don't I just try and do that and make a pick and place? So that's been the past year or so of my life.
That's cool.